In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this abstract art with a noise curve profile. Let's create a mesh that will be used as a continuous curve array filling mesh. Please make any shapes you like. We need to have two faces like these removed, so they can be filled into a curve properly. If you're planning to add loop cuts, please do so before removing the faces. Otherwise they will only work on one side. This is going to be my curve mesh's basic shape. I'll add two loop cuts on the side and the top and fill them with emission later. Type 3 to face select, and practice alt selecting face loops like this. We won't need the front and the back faces, let's remove them. The idea is to select and apply emission materials to the sides first. The primary material won't matter much, because only the faces in the middle will glow. I'll apply red and blue for the faces in the middle. Normally, I would do this. But in this example, we won't need that, because we'll adjust the camera's depth of field settings later. For the primary color, I'll just use a metallic one. Control 3 to subdivide. Right-click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. Type H to hide it. Let's create a noise curve profile. If you don't see that in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. Please experiment with the settings. We can use any shapes for this scene. Control 1 to subdivide. I'll use this camera angle to render. Alt H to unhide the mesh. Let's select the mesh and add array and curve modifiers. Please match my setting. We can either scale the mesh or the curve. When you're done scaling, Please select the mesh and press Ctrl, A, to reset all transforms. Please avoid scaling the mesh down way too much while the mesh was subdivided. That will slow the scene. Please remember to save the scene frequently. We can also change the curve settings. Please remember to increase the clip value for the camera, otherwise the full mesh might not show up. As usual, we can adjust the camera's focal length to create an interesting scene. I'll just change the focal length value to 25. Let's create a UV sphere and use that as a background mesh. I'll decrease the HDRI strength. Time to increase the emission strength. We could render the scene like this. I'll show you something better. Let's create an empty object and place it in front of the camera. Once we set the depth of field to the empty object, we'll end up with cool-looking visuals. Adjust the focal length value any way you like. This looks good. By the way, I'm using Eevee with Bloom. I'll show you what my denoise setting looks like. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.